time for Pants, and Pants was on FranLab.
Hey, it's Fran, again at the drawing table, with something new. This is the Kaküno, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, Introductory fountain pen by Pilot. Now, I have done videos on several introductory fountain pens, among them pens like the Uli, and the Preppy, and the Pilot Varsity, another Pilot pen. All of these very inexpensive introductory pens, the Pilot's actually intended to be disposable, although they can be refilled. I have refilled them, but it's not an ideal experience. They're not designed to be refilled, but the Varsity is still, I think, the most long-lasting. This particular Varsity is probably like about 10 years old, and it's still, you can uncap it and it still flows perfectly well. These Varsities, they're honestly perfectly sealed. They last a very long time. They write perfectly. They don't leak. You can carry them in your pocket. It's still probably the number one introductory fountain pen if you really want to get started without any kind of worries at all. The Pilot Varsity. The Uli, which I did a review of. I really liked this. I keep getting it upside down and backwards, but I really liked this pen when I first got it, and the review I did, it was very favorable. It's got, you know, a rubbery grip on it. It's kind of ergonomically shaped. It's got an interesting kind of style to it, and it writes very well. I said in the original review that, you know, when I first put the cartridge in, it was a very solid, good writer and smooth. And because I liked this pen so much when I got the first one, I got a couple more because they were very inexpensive. And I had one of these in every part of my shop. I think I had one in the office, one in the lab, one in the wood shop. But within weeks of my starting to use these, all three of the pens just froze up. And you can see this one, I really haven't used this pen, but the reservoir, you can see it completely dried up because these pens, the fatal flaw in the design is that the seal between the cap and the tip is imperfect, and it just allows all the ink to wick into the capillary parts of the tip and dry, and just becomes like a brick of dried ink in the end, and it's just, then the pen is useless. Not ruined. I mean, you can take the reservoir out, put the tip in some hot water overnight, and you know, you can rinse the ink out and refill it, but the problem is that it was just a design flaw. The seal between the cap and the nib is imperfect, and it allows the pen to dry out. All of my Ulis dried out within a couple of weeks. It makes it kind of a useless pen. The Preppy that I did a review on, I liked it a lot. I still like it, and the Preppy I've been using, this particular one I use every single day, just about, and the Preppy, unlike the Uli, it does not dry up. It's got a very good delivery system, and the tip is kind of uniquely designed, and the way it interfaces with the cap, you can see there's this kind of cone-shaped thing in the cap, and there's a spring, you see it in there, and when you put the tip back in the cap, you can see it interfaces with that cone, and then when you snap it shut, the spring keeps that under tension, and that is a perfect seal. You can spin the pen around in the cap, but it is not going to dry out. And I've been using this Preppy for years. It's never dried out on me, and it still is a very good writer. I just keep refilling it. Yeah, so I've had some luck and not luck with introductory fountain pens. And this new Pilot is it's very intriguing. Look at the back here. It says, simply the best choice for your first fountain pen. Okay. Perfect for beginners. Simple user guide included. All right. It says here, made by the Pilot Corp of America in Jacksonville, Florida, but made in Japan. Fountain pen, ink cartridge, and comes with different colored inks. I got some sepia. I like the more sepia inks for fountain pens. Never tried it before. This is a fine tip. I tend to not buy fine tip fountain pens because I find they tend to be squirrelier when starting out a line, and the medium tip fountain pens, they tend to deliver a more consistent line, especially when you're just starting out a line if you haven't used the pen in a little while. But the fine tip was all they had in stock for this, so that's what I got. Opens up. Okay. How to enjoy fountain pen. Okay, let's get started. Okay, well, so they give you a little instruction here. Get started, take off the cap. Shows you how to unscrew the barrel and push the ink cartridge straight in, yada yada. Okay. Alright, so nice little tips. Best choice in the first fountain pen. Alright, we have one pen, all clear. I really love the all clear pen. As you can tell from previous videos of fountain pens, my Lamy's, most of my Lamy's are clear. The Preppy's clear. I do like a clear fountain pen. Interesting, it's got that two-part cap again. You know, I think that's kind of vital in making a good seal. Oh, that's pretty positive. And turning the pen, you know, when you put the cap on and then turn it, you can really feel if the seal's good. If it's a very consistent tension, then you know that it's, you know, perfectly round on both sides. It's going to be a good seal. Interesting shape. Okay. All right. So, well, you see that little scoop on the inside? That goes into the hollow end of the cartridge. Break that membrane. Okay, and then it says in the instructions they want you to squeeze the barrel to force some ink. So let's see if that works without making too much of a mess. So you can see it right there. It says squeeze slightly. Oh, okay, there you go. It's not easy to squeeze. See the ink getting in there? There we go. Alright. Right. And if you make it easier on myself, since it's just starting out, if I'm filling my own cartridge, then the way that I start a fountain pen is I'll fill the cartridge and then I'll keep the well of ink that I filled it with, and I'll just dip the pen tip in the ink well once and then start writing, and that'll just draw the ink down. Still not the tip. I'm having to squeeze this a lot. Still not, yeah. There we go. That took a little while. Right, yeah, so feels good. It's got a slightly triangular shape on the area where you hold it, so there's a flat, you can't really see it in the video, but there's a flat side there for your thumb, a flat there for your forefinger, and a flat on the bottom for your middle finger, so it's a very positive, you know, feel. And again, this is an introductory pen, so they want to make it easy for you to hold the pen in the right angle, so. Very smooth. I like the ink shade, it's just about right. And speed. It's very fast ink delivery. No, that's it. Works well. The last test for this pen, like I said, you know, for all fountain pens that I have, is really if you start the pen, you have ink in it, you're writing with it, and then you just put the pen and you sit it down for a few days or for like a week, you go back to that pen, is it gonna write when you pick it up? That's the biggest test of a fountain pen. That really is the test of how well the tip seals, if it keeps the tip, you know, moist. If I pick this up in a week and it doesn't write, it's not gonna pass the test. But I gotta say, it's very well made all around. The tolerances, everything. You know, it is a Pilot, so they make great pens. Does it really replace the Varsity? You know, the Pilot Varsity? I don't know. Which is the greatest introductory fountain pen? Remains to be seen. But, yeah, there you go. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to all my patrons down on Patreon for making all these videos possible, including my crazy pen and pencil videos. But, you know, honestly, a lot of people really love the pen and pencil videos. I get emails all the time, people saying, keep doing the pen and pencil videos. So I will. I know that I've certainly got enough pens and pencils if you're doing this kind of video every week. So that's what I'm gonna do. All right, I'm Fran. I'll be back doing something, who knows what, lab, wood shop, who knows, real soon. All right, bye! In the lab. That's where I work. Berserk in my life.